Patients with Bell's palsy or vestibular schwannoma may have their facial nerve damaged. The severity of the damage can be assessed by determining the grade of asymmetries on their face. We'll now explain the most commonly used classification of facial nerve paralysis, the House-Brackman grading system. A completely healthy person starts with grade 1 and has normal control of his or her facial muscles. They can easily move their forehead muscles, mouth, and eyes without any issue. People with mild dysfunction are assigned with grade 2. At rest, their faces look normal and symmetrical. Their forehead moves, observed by raising the eyebrows, are limited on a reasonable level, and their mouths are slightly asymmetrical when smiling, which is only noticeable on close inspection. Their eyes can be closed completely with minimal effort, but synkinesis, or the involuntary muscle pull or spasm that follows a voluntary movement, may slightly be present in the area of the nose, cheek, or mouth. Grade 3 is to classify people with moderate dysfunction. At rest, their faces are still symmetrical and in a normal tone, but the level of movement in their forehead is almost halved and their mouths may feel slightly weak, resulting in about the same asymmetry as before, but with maximum effort. Similarly, their eyes can only be closed completely with higher effort, and the synkinesis becomes more obvious. All in all, there is a clear but not disfiguring difference on both sides of the face when moving. A more serious dysfunction in grade 4 is still allowing a normal facial symmetry and tone at rest, but the other indicators are worsening. The forehead no longer has any movement, and the mouth has become asymmetric, although a maximum effort is exerted. Their eyes, even with maximum effort, are unable to shut completely. The synkinesis becomes more severe, creating a more obvious disfiguring asymmetry and weakness in the face. The next grade, grade 5, covers people with severe dysfunction. Their faces already show asymmetries even at rest. Their forehead stays paralyzed, and their mouth only shows a slight movement. Their eyes stay half open. Synkinesis no longer occurs, as the facial muscles are too weak for any additional movement. This gives an overall impression that there is a barely perceptible motion in this group's faces. People in grade 6 suffer total paralysis. On the weak side of their face, there is no movement, neither from the forehead, mouth, nor eyes.